is it, Richard?
Well, Dad, I'm 17, and I think it's time that I learned responsibility.
Bringing up kids today is a lot different to when Bryce Dallas Howard's own dad was starring in Happy Days.
You're going to be depending on me someday, you know.
Don't threaten me, Richard.
At his best, a father provides a kind of consistent sense of safety and therefore possibility.
For her new documentary titled Dads, the actress-turned-director shines a light on the role fathers play in raising a child.
I laughed, I wept, and I smiled because there were just so many beautiful moments. Why did you want to do this?
I am the product of a dad who is super committed to fathering and just at all times, still to this day, I'm 39 years old, trying his hardest to do his best, and his best is pretty beautiful and pretty extraordinary. And yet, in TV shows and oftentimes in books and in documentaries and all of that, depictions of fathers are largely unflattering and not actually what, at least what I've seen in reality. I think that's harming our families, it's harming our fathers, it's harming our children, and it's harming our mothers, definitely.
The documentary features not only normal dads from across the globe, but a bunch of celebrity dads.
You've got Conan, you've got Neil Patrick Harris, you've got Will Smith, you've got various assorted late night Jimmys. They all tell beautiful stories, but the one that sticks in my mind is Jimmy Kimmel and a projectile vomiting situation.
Just kind of holding her over my head, and I was smiling, I had my mouth wide open, and she had her mouth wide open, and then she vomited in a forceful column, I guess they call it projectile vomiting, directly into, like, it hit my uvula.
I just right away was like, well, if it's about fathering, it's a comedy. You know, in order to make it universal, it needs to be specific. And so let's find specific stories around the world of fathers doing their thing.
Papa!
Thank you.
What else I learned is that dads just can't handle poop.
When I went online and saw the reactions to poop, I was like, it's okay to highlight this because it's something that, like, I hope dads don't feel so alone when it's like there's all these notions of masculinity and all of that, and you're seeing these guys heaving at the sight of a diaper, and that's how it is. And one day, maybe that heaving will pass. But stick with it, fellas. Stick with it.
Not everybody can make it to every game or any game. Not everybody can sit there and do homework with their kid because they might be carrying three jobs.
Three generations of Howards appear in the doco, though Bryce's Oscar-winning dad, Ron, was a reluctant participant.
At the time, I was like, I have some footage of my own grandfather who is a huge influence to our family, and my dad was like, let me stop you there. No, you're not including our family in this. But then I really needed an expecting father, and my brother ended up sharing that he and his wife were expecting their first baby. And so the Howard family story was a little bit of not something that was necessarily intended, but ultimately ended up working out.
We learn your dad filmed all of your births. Why did he do that? And what impact do you think that's had on you? Being able to watch your own birth in somewhat graphic detail, I understand.
Yes. My parents have a friend named Mark Wheeler. Mark was the one videoing everything and going around and interviewing people and whatnot. At the time, it was really unconventional. I'm just so glad that they thought to do that. You know, it's really special to get to witness the passage of time for real, and our kids are gonna always have that. But I had one of my friends video my birth. He was so freaked out that when he came in, he like went into the corner and started meditating. But anyway, it's my friend who married me, and then he could handle marrying me, but he couldn't handle taping it.
I was born to make you happy.
Bryce was just 7 when she made her film debut in her dad's 1989 comedy, Parenthood. She now has close to 40 film roles on her resume, and we'll see her next in the upcoming Jurassic World, Dominion. But has being the daughter of one of Hollywood's most successful actor directors helped or hindered her career?
It must have helped. I feel like it's helped, and I'm sure it's helped in ways that I'm entirely unaware of. In terms of negative stuff, I wouldn't say in a way that has been detrimental in any way, shape, or form, you know, other than sometimes my feelings get a little bit hurt, but that's okay. When you're working in a creative, kind of unconventional profession, having a parent that understands that at all is a huge advantage. You don't necessarily inherit sort of like the psychic baggage of your parent being like, you'll never make a living, or like, you know what I mean? Like, but what's your real job? They were like, who knows if you'll make a living at it, but yeah, of course, we love it, do it, go for it. And just be prepared to have a lot of side jobs. And I was like, yeah, check, got it. And so I think that that alone, having emotionally supportive parents, was a huge advantage. In addition to that, my dad's not a jerk. People have positive associations with him. I felt really bad for some folks that I know who have parents that are well known who aren't really cool and kind of suck, you know, and now I can still go to my dad and ask him advice, and it's extremely, extremely positive. And if I could share what I've been able to experience and, you know, in having a childhood with a dad like my dad, I absolutely would, because it's awesome.
Bryce, thank you so much for chatting with me today. I could talk to you for hours about this film. I absolutely love it. Congratulations. And hopefully when the pandemic's over, we'll see you in Australia soon.
Thank you. I hope so too. Thank you.
Daddy?
Wow. Yes, LG?
I love you all of my big heart.
Oh, you do? Oh, thank you. Thank you. Oh, wow.
Daddy?
Wow. Ooh.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm crying.